vary.
Somewhat. Just put chocolate on it. It'll be fine.
Yeah.
We had a nice day. It was amazing how within literally an hour or two, it was like, oh, yeah, that rain was out of here.
Yeah, it was out of here. Quick clearing. We're now dry above the surface and at the surface. We're going to stay that way tonight, but the clouds sinking down to the surface, and that means some fog overnight. Areas of dense fog for the area. Much drier, though, again, from the last 12 to 18 hours. Here's a look at that radar review. The showers and storms, they were all over the place from last night through this morning. We got a slight break for only a few hours for a couple spots, and then it returned. It's out of here now. That same low pressure system taking aim on the eastern side of the United States, stretching all the way up into parts of West Virginia. But the strongest weather remains right around Florida tonight and the Florida Panhandle. We did have some imprints left from that storm in the form of a storm report and some wind gusts very strong across the area. Gulfport, a 60 mile per hour gust from that same storm. We also saw multiple trees and power lines down in the past Christian area this morning. And then we can't leave out, of course, the coastal sections, the Louisiana coast, 63 mile per hour wind gusts at Grand Isle today. Those winds much calmer now, literally in the calm state, but still the water remains. We still have some flood warnings, mainly for the North Shore, extending into Mississippi, Pearl and Hancock counties. We saw quick drying today. You can see those westerly winds and those southerly winds crisscrossing each other this afternoon, but the skies cleared out and we're left with mainly clear skies. Now we'll see some clouds moving in overnight. 63 to 67 degrees. Some of us a little cooler than that, right around those lower 60s. Winds out of the south, 0 to 10 miles per hour. The rainfall over the last 24 hours, near 5.5 inches for our friends to the west, Audubon Park, over 3.5 inches. That's actually a daily rainfall record that was reached, and a little over 3.5 inches for Slidell. Again, the cloud cover working out of here. We're looking dry. We'll be high and dry for the next few days. Maybe an isolated shower, but not until Tuesday or Wednesday. So look forward to dry conditions. Monday, again, the fog rolling on into the area. Clearing out by the afternoon, we'll stay with partly sunny skies throughout the day on Monday. And things much nicer again through Tuesday and Wednesday, and warmer, in fact. Our next system will develop out in the west. That's what we're watching. It'll bring us a chance for severe storms later on in the week. Here's your hour-by-hour forecast starting at 6 o'clock, upper 60s. Mild and humid, warmer in the afternoon, lower 80s throughout the day. Right now, where are we? We're in the 60s, 69 for Grand Isle, 68 degrees. Right now for Boothville, and those temperatures moving up. We'll notice the change today. Houston, upper 70s, lower 80s for Dallas. We'll get those temperatures tomorrow. Here's a look at your week ahead. Low to middle 80s through Tuesday and Wednesday. Overnight lows in the upper 60s and right around 70 degrees. A very major drop off in temperatures by the end of the week with that strong cold front by next Saturday. Only upper 60s.
It looks pleasant though all week.
Yeah, until Thursday.
Yeah, well.
Yeah.
My days off look good. That's all that matters.
Oh, that's right.
All right. Thank you
all
so much.
All about you, Rach.
That's right.